You know, a lot of our viewers, they play the leverage market. At these levels, is it advisable to really stay away from the leverage market, futures and options, options and futures, call and puts?
See, this is, I would say that investors, they are only playing into these games. If they are doing it for hedging purposes, it's fine. But normally what happens is these, all these options and all, they turn into speculative elements, and that's where it becomes a crocodile spawn. And you see the crisis in 2008 which we saw is because of these options. And these futures options, they are not able to give us the right value of the stock, like gold, the way the gold is going up. Because you can buy in futures, you can buy in this thing, you can have your options trading, all those derivatives are making this thing, the price rigging very easy. That's happening with Nifty, that's happening with the BSE Sensex, it's happening all over.
Mm-hmm. Now, you've identified two stocks for us, Noida Toll Bridge and Standard Chartered IDR, which is listed in India. But again, a lot of our retail viewers are watching this show, they have limited appetite to only buy one stock. Should they split the money into two or only buy one stock?
One is, if you have a limited appetite, if you have the money, this thing, as a matter of discipline, you should not be putting in one stock, however good the idea may be. This thing, more than about between 5 to 10% in a single stock of your total net worth.
So divide the money into two. Don't just buy one Noida Toll Bridge or Standard Chartered. If you have limited appetite, so be it, but divide that limited capital.
No, well, I would say now today, if you can invest into the international markets also, now we can. A company like Nestle is quoting here at more than 40 times. I will not buy a Nestle over here. Now, Nestle is basically a Swiss company.
So buy the
here also. It's a global company. Okay. A lot of businesses from India and from the. It's a global company.
What about the currency risk? If you're buying global denominated stocks, you're buying them in dollar. Dollar is looking weak. So if you're investing right now, if dollar falls down, rather than appreciation, you actually will have a net depreciation.
I agree with you, but see, now those risks we every time take, you know, every time take. And since we have not invested in the global world, then these are the things which we'll have to be with. But if I know that Nestle is available about 14 to 15 times in the US markets, I will buy those stocks, they're saying. If it's a great company, I love it over here. It's too expensive over here. Why not buy the same company when it's got major of its businesses in the Asian region?
Rakesh, stay with us. One more break on markets. Mantra, when we come back, it's going to be Q4 next week. Welcome back. You're watching Markets Mantra on ET Now, and we are in conversation with Mr. Parag Parekh. Parag, we've looked at opportunities. Now let's talk about threats. From here to March and from March to next Diwali, which to your mind are the biggest challenges for Indian markets?
Actually, if you go to see if the way the real estate prices and all are going up, what does that show? That our money is losing purchasing power. We got a lot of poor people in this country.
So simplify
the
that.
The growth has to percolate down to them. And in real estate, most of the people buying this expensive real estate properties are investors, thinking they'll make money. You got to realize one thing, that whom will you sell to? It's something like in stocks also. And can a poor person getting a salary of a lakh of rupees a month, can he really afford the prices which are prevailing today, not
so
only in South Bombay?
Real estate prices are a bubble, or real estate stocks also are a bubble?
I think real estate stocks definitely I don't like, and real estate itself is a bubble, because when will people go when it is affordable? Today everything is becoming beyond the reach of affordable.
But real estate always has been unaffordable, Parag. If you look at market history, if you look at Indian market history, you know, 5 years ago when Bombay was available at 50% rates, flats were unaffordable. 20 years ago when flats were available at 10% rates, that time also according to the income level 10 years ago, it was still unaffordable.
Correct. Yes. Then how many times a slump also followed that, no? They are unaffordable is one part, but it just cannot go. Then there becomes a slump. When the slump comes, there are people who get in, and then again you have craziness going on. See, we are talking about the market craziness. Real estate, we all require real estate. That's why we believe that is there. But what is the pricing? What is the pricing? Then we'll have ghost cities, because in China they already have ghost cities. where cities are there, concrete jungle, mm-hmm. but why are people not buying? Because they cannot afford to go there. Mm-hmm. And then slowly, slowly, when that demand, this thing goes down, just now the demand is there for the investors, mm-hmm. because banks are giving loans. But then, over a period of time, then you find what are the outgoings, what are the variable, what is that interest factor, how it eats away into your capital. That's where people start realizing. That's where the bankruptcies come.
Mm-hmm. Right. On this forum, Parag, last time when we met, you had also identified ICRA for our viewers. Do you still like ICRA?
Yeah, definitely. It's a great business. Business easy to understand. Credit rating agency. A client goes to them, gives their own balance sheet. On that strength of the balance sheet, this company rates them and they get a fee. Every year, whether they get a B plus or an A plus, they have to ultimately go and get themselves credit rated. Then, what does this business require? Office space which can be leased out. Not very smart people, adequate people who are able to crunch the numbers. They have a software in place. It's a great business to be in.
But if I look at the growth rate, the top line growth rate, it's about 15 to 20%. That's very mellow.
What do you mean mellow, Nikunj? I think 15% growth rate compounded over a period of 10.
This is not a large base.
Yeah, correct. But see, today in these markets, we have been accustomed to looking at 30% mila, 40% mila. These things are not sustainable. I would rather have something 15 to 20% sustainable rather than 30-40. Whereas you had the tech boom, everyone was talking about 50%, 60%. Was it sustainable? It cannot be sustainable. And that's what happening in the markets. Today the markets are giving you a wrong impression, because when you are looking at the real relative return of a stock which has gone up so much, either 30 million, either 40 million, it's speculatively it's going up. That's why you are making that money. But if you have put your money in a business which gives me 15 to 20% return, I would love that business. You show me, I'll buy those businesses.
So mean reversion essentially is a truism of capitalism.
Yes.
If one looks at the basic structure of Indian markets, Parag, you have foreign institutional investors which are coming there, and retail activity is not there. Domestic institutional investors are selling on every uptick, which means retail investors are not back. Markets historically have always peaked out when there is retail euphoria. Is that the current judgment to
understand? Yes. Now there are two ways to see it. That retail investors have become wiser, because we always learn from our mistakes. So I think they may be learning from the mistakes, but when the retail investors get crazy and they pay anything for an IPO, that is where I think it's time to worry. And if you see, IPOs are getting a lukewarm response. On listing, people are not making money, so they are really going slow. And I think that's the maturity of our Indian markets.
That retail investors are now, or retail investors are now separating the wheat from the chaff.
Yeah, they are. But the problem with this is, this markets never has institutional memory. Because more and more youngsters come into the market, mm-hmm. so when those people come, the institution memory on the market is lost, because those people come with no institution memory and they get into instant gratification and they start then buying anything at any price. Then they lose, they become wiser, either come back to the markets or go out of the markets.
You've also recommended some pharma stocks for us on this forum. Do you like MNC Pharma names, the ones you recommended last time? Do you still like them? Let me rephrase this one.
Yeah, if I don't have any opportunity in the pharma sector of a good stock, then I would really hold on to those pharma sectors. But some of them, if they are becoming highly expensive, we definitely take a call.
Right. Good to have you on, Nitin.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much for joining us, and thank you for sharing
some ideas with us.
Before we wrap those ideas, which Parag has identified for our viewers, will just come up on your screen. Thanks for watching this edition of Markets Mantra. Have a great weekend. I'm Nikunj Dalmia, signing off.